Hi, I'm Jean Stoppelstead. I'm a member of the Minnesota Catholic Conference's Life, Healthcare, and Family Committee. I'm also the director of the Archdiocesan Office of Marriage, Family, and Life. But more importantly, like you, I'm a Minnesota Catholic, and we are called to bring our faith into the public square. On February 25th, we have a great opportunity to do this at our local precinct caucuses. Now, if you've never caucused before, or maybe you're just not convinced it's worth your time, keep listening. This may look like an ordinary gym, but in a few weeks' time, places just like this all over our state are going to be transformed into centers for the democratic process. Places just like this is where it all begins. I know that many of you are probably sick of politics, the bickering, the ads, the divisiveness, the appearance that things never change for the good. But they can change if people like you get involved. Caucuses are our chance to elevate the common good. So, what can you expect at your caucus? Let me break it down for you into five simple steps. Step one, you need to find out where you're going. Minnesota Catholic Conference has made this super simple for you. Simply go to mncatholic.org/caucus, and they have a caucus finder right on their website. Step two, grab a couple of friends. Now, I'm really serious about this. Get a couple of your friends to join you, but more the merrier. And besides, if you propose a resolution, your friends are probably going to help you ensure that it gets passed. Now, we'll talk about resolutions more in just a minute. But first, I want to talk about step three, because it's the most important. You need to show up. Arrive at your precinct caucus probably about 6:30 or so. Sign in, get a cup of coffee, couple cookies, and you and your buddies go and mingle with your neighbors. Find out what's important to them and share your ideas as well. The precinct caucus will begin promptly at 7. Step four, participate. Don't hesitate to ask questions, to seek clarification, or to find out why or how. Step five, the resolution. Now this is the fun part. This is where those ideas that you care very strongly about find their way into the public conversation. This is where you begin to influence your party's platform. Again, the Minnesota Catholic Conference has made this super simple. They have a list of many resolutions that are important to all of us on their website. You can download these and use them at either the DFL caucus or the Republican caucus. Or they have templates that you can use to write your own. The idea is that you prepare ahead of time and write down what you want to say so that you don't have to think too fast on your feet, or if you're nervous, it's just right there on the piece of paper. After you give your resolution, you sit down and the group votes on it. Those resolutions that receive a majority vote go on to the next level of state representation. They might even find their way into the national platform, and then you'd have influence at a national level. And all of that started in a little gym like this. Before the caucuses close, you will elect delegates to represent you at the state level and maybe even the national convention. You will also take a straw poll on the presidential candidates. Caucus night is fun, it's exciting, and it's influential. Let's together bring our Catholic voice to the caucuses across the state to advocate for life, dignity, and the common good.